And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 2 Blind. I'm the RPG chick. Gonna finish checking out. We just disabled the Geth device in here and fully mapped out the Dirada system and hear that? There's something right there. I guess we're going to... You hear it? Okay, I was trying to remember this is not the system with the mass relay and such. Go back here, kind of on the way. Fuel up. Moved and I meant to click that. Oh, that other one's way over there. Satent? Alright, looks like we got a four planet system going on here. And this planet's called Raceris. An airless rock of mixed light ores, Raceris is only of note for the Terrienu impact crater. A relatively recent asteroid strike within the last million years, the core of the object was partly composed of element zero. It struck at a low enough velocity that the easel remained near the surface. Over the years, many pirates and wildcat miners have attempted to extract the ore. It is believed that the Terrienu debris originated in the pulsar system stuff. The supernova that formed the pulsar also created the red emission nebula that human spacers have unofficially named the Sakura Nebula. Unofficially named. Isn't Sakura have some kind of hentai kind of thing?
Launching probe.
We have over 100,000 element zero. Now it would stop mining. Who needs all of it? But
probe launched.
Now that makes it more interesting. I don't know. Just to see how much I could possibly get. And some of you guys like watching it for some reason, so there you go.
Probe launched.
Stuff. Can we get it bigger here?
Probe launched.
That's a moderate amount right there. And wait. I was just about to give up.
Probe away.
105,000. Alright, good enough. And the second planet is... Anidia. Anidia is a small ice body with a very low density. Its mass is only 4% that of Earth. Its math sucks. It appears to be composed mainly of carbon and water ice, but over the millennia it has accrued a trace atmosphere of krypton and xenon. While Anedia's gravity is weak enough that a cruiser could land on it safely, there is no particular reason one would want to. Pirates have been known to land to recover ice for cracking into hydrogen and oxygen. One area in the southern hemisphere, the so-called Anedian Scrapes, is so frequently used for this purpose that higher albedo raw ice can be easily seen from orbit. Okay. That what we're looking at? Some of this ice from orbit? Doesn't appear to be any element zero here on this planet. Okay. Then we will bid it adieu. Third planet is Boro. Boro is a young Volus colony world settled in defiance of a threat by Terminus pirate groups. The pirates, who can't use the world themselves, have suggested that the Volans hire them to protect the colony. The Volus responded by requesting military protection from their Turian allies. Although uncomfortably hot by Volus standards, Boro has the rare combination of high pressure and ammonia ecology Volus require. Development of the colony is proceeding rapidly. Colony was founded in 2180, population 1617, and the capital is Yila. Or Yila. And they are rich in resources. Oh, including some Ezo here.
Launching probe.
Yeah, that's a good spike right there.
Away.
Any more? Here's some.
Probe away.
Oh, what was that?
Probe launched.
Okay. What? Every time I'm about to give up, I find more.
Launching probe.
Nice. Over 110k. More.
Probe launched.
Great planet if you're looking for some Ezo, guys. Righty. And the other planet in the system. That's some as well. And the last planet is Nataza. An unremarkable methane ammonia gas giant, Nataza would be of no consequence if it wasn't the only approachable gas giant in the Satan system. Boro's Volus colony has set up a few automated ice-cracking stations around the planet, and Narhu Combine has been contracted to set up a helium-3 extraction facility. Construction has lagged due to the CEO's arrest in a kickback scandal that reaches to the highest levels of the Vol Ministry of the Frontier. Really? Alright, well, let's see what there is here, then. In light of this scandal. Not that much. Yeah, I'd say we're done with this system. Yeah. No probe. 80%. There must be something else. What are we looking for? Whence comes it? Ah! There's another planet that we can't even see? Oh. I think I couldn't tell that. Wait. I guess it's like in front of the sun or behind it? Ruskell? Rascal? Ruskell is a massive hot Jupiter gas giant that whips around the star Satan once every 4.5 days. Wow. Like most planets of its type, it migrated inwards from its initial position in the system, thought to be around 0.3 AU. Ruskell is one of the few close-orbiting gas giants to show a marked temperature difference in its sun-facing and dark side hemispheres. The atmosphere absorbs and re-radiates Satan's heat too quickly for winds to carry the heat to the dark side. There is a temperature difference of over 1,000 degrees between the gas giant's hot and cold poles. Okay. Oh, moderate results. Can barely tell that we're moving the planet around here. And I don't think we're going to find any element zero at all. Okay. Now we're done. Alright, nothing happened here at all. Nothing that interesting. And before I go all this way, I mean, I could probably make it there and all the way back, but let's be careful. Let's be cautious. And refuel. And then head straight there. Or more or less straight there. Chris or I? So he used up about 400 to get there. Okay. Bunch of planets. Seem to spread out as they get farther away from the sun. Nidus. Nidus lies improbably close to the red dwarf Chrysorai. This allows it to approach habitability, although it is quite frigid. It is tidally locked with a hot pole and a cold pole. Along the terminator, the temperature averages just above freezing. On the lee side, the temperatures are well below freezing. Nidus has developed a limited native ecology. Much of it clusters permanently attached around geothermal vents. There are, however, more advanced forms of life. Several arthropodal herbivore species wander back and forth across the terminator as they require nutrients available in both environments for sustenance. More dangerous are the omnivorous predator species that devour the arthropods. Most animal life on Nidus has limited vision but finely developed thermal sense. Really? They can sense temperature to a greater degree. Moderate. Not really finding anything we need here. Theonax. That's a cool name. Theonax's surface is covered by water and ammonia hydrate ices, which are constantly repaved by cryovolcanic processes. The world's size and density suggest the core contains heavier elements and retains much of the heat of the system's formation. Let's see if we can find any Ezo here on this one. Not finding the stuff. Okay. Third planet? Uzin. A typical methane ammonia ice giant, Uzin has 37 moons of various sizes. What is it? Chithes, one of the largest, orbits at a retrograde, suggesting it was a planetesimal that was captured by the gas giant gravity well. The planet itself is believed to be an extrasolar capture as well, though millions of years before Chithes came on the scene. Evidence collected by planetary geologists suggests that Chithes was for many centuries a water world, heated by tidal flexing as its orbit circularized around Uzin. The planetary ocean, once hundreds of kilometers deep, must now be frozen solid. Some have recommended drilling test bores to see if life ever developed in Uzin seas, but the question is considered academic. Well, let's see if there's anything here. And by anything I mean element zero. Never thought we'd have over 100,000, that's insane. Struggling just to have enough in the beginning of the game. How things change, huh? Okay. Apparently two more planets? 1, 2, 3. This is Nidus, right? Alright. Looking for another hidden planet here. Alright. Geus is another methane ammonia gas giant, very similar to its near twin Uzin. It presents a nearly featureless robin egg blue like face to the surface. Or without the like. Completely sure if I've ever seen element zero on a gas giant or in a gas giant, but I will look anyway. So pretty uneventful rest of this star cluster, huh? Let's move on. Yeah, 80%, this will be the last one. Tenoth. Tenoth is little more than a glorified ice dwarf that has drifted inwards from Chrysoroi's Oort cloud over the millennia. Its extremely elliptical orbit is ultimately unstable. Computer projections suggest it will impact the atmosphere of Geus in a few billion years. We don't have a few billion years. We're gonna look for this crap here and not find it, which is okay because we have plenty. Whenever we find something that requires element zero, it's a small amount anyway. Alright, 100%, we're done with the entire Pylos Nebula. How about that?
One half capacity.
That's why I fueled up like that. Let's hit the mass relay. Bloop. Gonna head towards. Why does this still say this? Disable Geth device. I want to check this. Is this something? Is this something I didn't do? You know, I think I might... I'm sorry, guys. I think it's been a few days since I played. I think I saved this, but didn't actually go down on the planet. Doing a lot of Geth stuff and Android stuff, like mech stuff. So I got it confused. Yeah, let's not leave until we... Well, take care of this. Yeah, I was specifically looking to see which, you know, if the labels have disappeared, like, we almost have, like, no labels left, that kind of thing. And I'm like, this one's still here, we just left it. Alright, so... I'm gonna take Garrus for his overload, even though hers is better. And Tally for the hacking crowd control aspect. I still have to mess around with the energy drain. Once I come across things that have energy, not energy, shields I mean, and they have zero, then I can mess around with it and see how we do. See how much of a difference it makes. On them, at least. Oh, hello, Radgath. Aren't you a badass? Yeah. Well, I'm glad I didn't forget about this. Really hard to see here. Okay, what's our objective again? Anomalous weather detected. Disable the Geth climate change device. Wow. Foggy and spooky, man. That's a big drop, I guess. Good thing you can't actually fall off stuff like that. Here's some palladium. 100 of it. Anything up here? More palladium? Got a lot of palladium. 200? I wonder if they're going to be able to see us before we see them. 100? Checking around to see if I can find more. 100. We don't need it, but if it's here, I'm getting it. That makes any sense. Oh, what happened here? I don't even know which way they're coming from. Cool song, though. Is there anyone around, or we're just taking out our weapons randomly? I'm not sure if they saw anybody. They didn't start firing. Alright, let's head up then. Why, hello there. Armor piercing ammo. Hack it. That one's still attacking, at least. Can't even see the damn things. That's my shield here. That works pretty well, I like that. I think we could spare it. God, I got closer. I can't even see these damn things. I took its shields right out. Look at that. That's awesome. So far, I like the shield thing the best.
Put them up.
Scratch one.
Good. More geth I can't see. Pretty nimble over there, guys. Not charging now. I missed or something? I hear another. Oh. And I kind of see another.
Nothing's faster than
not working. It's not working, I don't know why. It was like alternating between them. Oh, now it works. I just can't do it from over there for some strange reason.
Fire in the hole!
I guess I'm missing that thing. That's it, we can save. Okay, cool. I think we're already full of clips. So as opposed to the beginning of my playthrough, when I barely used my powers at all, now I'm barely using my rounds. There's some more palladium over there. I don't want to miss stuff, but it's just so murky, I can't see. 200 palladium there. Save. Now I'm like, what's that? Hope I can go inside somewhere where it's not so foggy. Palladium. Keep saving. Cause I don't know what the hell's around the next corner. There's some palladium over there. And some there. Two hundred. I hear combat music again. Oh, I didn't mean to hit that. I don't see one coming. Where's more? 200. Music stopped again. Alright. Holding on to my palladium collection here. I guess we're still save though, which means we're not in combat. Which I can also tell because no one's shooting at me. There's more palladium over here. Hold up. I might want to be on this side.
They've seen us.
Yep. How'd I know? Guys, you should get some cover. I guess I should get closer with my friends here. Well, that one's running fast. Drain the shields.
Their shields are mine.
So around some cover, it's not working, huh? Don't get that. Okay. We can save once again. Get device. I know I keep saving. I don't like I can't see this crap. Palladium. That's pretty cool looking, huh? This is it. 200 palladium, get device. Saving again. Hello. What happens to me now?
I'll take it.
Yeah, I'll take whatever I can get. 125 experience. We're now level 26 with another squad point. Recovered Geth climate change technology. Okay, so we got a shield upgrade. I didn't even notice getting that. Squad bonus plus 50% to shields, barrier, and armor. That'll definitely help. 7,500 credits earned. Palladium is 2,000. Bloop. Cool. Message? No message? I'm always surprised when there's no messages. Okay. Now let's take a look at the... Can't believe you guys are probably yelling and like, you left the thing. Now it's empty. Now the thing isn't there. Now that's always going to be there because I'm telling us where Omega and the Shadow Broker base is. We should go back there soon. And Crescent Nebula, Ilium, Citadel. So we still got that. And we got that. And we got that. We got three systems left. Pretty cool. So, yeah, stay tuned for next episode when we head to one of them. Endure. In Enduring. Cross strong.